Good afternoon, all of you. In this video, I want to discuss about the neurons. This is content which I am going to explain. So, what is neurons? Neurons are a particular type of nerve cell that carry information, messages or signals to and from the brain and the rest of the body. See here, if you see the figure, you can understand it consists of cell body, dendrites, nucleus of nerve cell, axon, myelin sheath, neurilemma, nucleus of Schwann cell, dorsoganglion, and axon terminal. This is the axon terminals, and this small dot is there. It is called botons. So here I have written here myelinated neurons and non-myelinated neurons. So what is the difference between myelinated neurons and non-myelinated neurons? In the myelinated neurons, myelin sheath is there, whereas in the non-myelinated neurons, it does not have any myelin sheath. Okay, so now coming to the properties of neurons. Each neuron consists of a cell body and its process, one axon and many dendrites. Neurons cannot divide, and for survival they need a continuous supply of oxygen and glucose. Now question is, why neurons cannot divide? Neurons cannot divide because we know for a cell to divide, it should undergo either mitosis or meiosis. As neurons are somatic cells, then they should undergo mitosis. But for mitosis to occur, centrioles should move to the poles and should develop spindle fibers that pull the chromosomes. So, neurons lack the centrioles, and hence mitosis is not possible, and so they cannot divide. Neurons generate and transmit electrical impulse, which is called the action potential. The initial strength of the impulse is maintained throughout the length of the neurons. Some neurons initiate nerve impulses, while others act as relay station where impulses are passed down and sometimes redirected. Now, what is relay station? Relay station is nothing but it is a communication system for disseminating information. Okay. Now coming to the point, cell bodies. Nerve cell vary considerably in size and shape, but they are also too small to be seen by the naked eye. Cell bodies from the gray matter of the nervous system and are found at the periphery of the brain and in the center of the spinal cord. So what is the location of the gray matter? See here. It is found at the periphery of the brain and in the center of the spinal cord. And what is the gray matter? Gray matter is the darker pinkish gray colored tissue of the brain and spinal cord, which consists of nerve cell bodies and branching dendrites. Group of cell body are called nuclei in the central nervous system, And in the peripheral nervous system, it's called the ganglia. So here, figure number 2, see, Salvodis. This is the Salvodis of neuron or nerve cell. It consists of polyribosome, ribosome, Golgi apparatus, nucleus, nucleolus, membrane, microtubules, mitochondrion, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum and synapse. And this is the axon hillock. So here, axon. Each nerve cell has only one axon, which is carrying nerve impulses away from the cell body. These are usually longer than the dendrites, sometimes as long as 100 cm. See here, axon. It is longer in size, but dendrites is smaller than the axon. The dendrites are the many short processes that receive and carry incoming impulses towards the cell bodies. They have the same structure as axon, but they are usually shorter and branching. See here, small branches there, but in axon it does not have any branch. So here I have mentioned the myelin sheath. Now what is myelin sheath? Myelin sheath is a fatty insulating layer that surrounds the nerve cell. Fatty insulating layer. Now what is fatty insulating layer? Fatty insulating means fatty protecting layer that surrounds the nerve cell. And what is the nodes of Ranvier? Node of Ranvier is a gap in the myelin sheath of a nerve. See here, one small gap is there. Small gap is there between the adjacent C1 cell. See, these two is C1 cell and this is a node of Ranvier. Now, what is C1 cell? C1 cell is a myelin secreting glial cells. Myelin secreting glial cells. And what is synapse? Synapse is a junction between two nerve cells which helps to transfer electric activity from one cell to another. So it is a junction between two nerve cells. If you see the figure number 4, you can understand that it is a junction between two nerve cells. This is one nerve cell and this is another nerve cell, and this is a junction and this is called the synapse. And this is the axon terminals, dendrites, cell body, mitochondria.